Well, whales are really acoustically active, so they use noise to find food, to communicate, and to navigate. And if there's too much noise in the environment, they might not be able to do those aspects of their life effectively. Well, basically, we're trying to understand how ocean noise is impacting these whales. Increased ocean noise from vessel traffic, from Navy sonar, from oil and gas exploration, all of that might impact the way whales are able to find food or communicate, or over time just stress them out more. We're measuring health by looking at their body condition. So we're flying a drone over the whales and collecting information on how fat and happy they are. And then we also can look at their stress levels by collecting fecal samples. And fecal samples from whales contain a heap of great biological information. We can look at their reproductive hormones, their stress hormones, and their genetics. It's a moment of complete movement on the boat. Everybody goes right into action. Somebody screams, poop, and the driver gets on the engine and drives us right over the sample. Somebody dives for the net, and the other person's pointing and talking about where the sample is in the water. So the whole process takes maybe 20 seconds, but it's a really crucial 20 seconds to get right on the sample before it sinks and to be able to get the right sample. We're able to look at the animal behavior in a completely different perspective. So before, in a boat, we only could see the animal surface and then go back under. And now we can watch them from above, again, non-invasively, and see exactly what they're doing underwater, how they're moving, how they're feeding. We're noticing that the animals are quite bendy and flexible. They're doing a lot of headstands when they're feeding underwater. And all that information is brand new that we weren't able to collect before.